With a sleek, fastback body, 20-inch wheels and aggressive styling mods, the RS7 could get by on looks alone, but as an RS model, that's not necessary. This fan burner packs a spectacular twin-turbo 4.0-liter V8 that makes 560 horsepower, a performance-tuned 8-speed automatic, all-wheel drive, and a lowered suspension. For more power, the RS7 Performance makes 605 horsepower. While the six-figure price tag is not cheap, the RS7 is as close as it gets to an R8 supercar with four doors and a hatch. Few would call the 560 horsepower Audi RS7 underpowered. Yet Audi still felt it necessary to breathe more grunt into the RS7's twin-turbocharged 4.0-liter V8 engine. Dubbed the Audi RS7 Performance, the 605 horsepower model was introduced last year. Its extra power comes courtesy of a new turbocharger design, more efficient intercooler heat exchangers, a reprogrammed engine computer, and revised camshafts that activate new exhaust valves. A maximum of 553 pounds-foot of torque is available from 2,500 revolutions per minute to 5,500 revolutions per minute in a temporary overboost mode. Normally, the engine makes 516 pounds-foot at 1,750 revolutions per minute and rides a wave that peaks at 6,000 revolutions per minute, 500 revolutions per minute higher than the standard car's peak and only 800 revolutions per minute short of redline. At 4,487 pounds, our test car carried 34 extra pounds of machine compared with the last RS7 we tested, an insignificant increase in the face of the performance model's 45 additional thoroughbreds. 0 to 60 miles per hour takes just 3.2 seconds, 0 to 100 miles per hour requires 7.3, and the quarter mile zips by after 11.3 seconds, at which point the RS7 is traveling 125 miles per hour. Those figures are 0.2, 0.5, and 0.3 second better than the standard car, and the quarter mile trap speed is 2 miles per hour faster. A standard dual-mode exhaust system emits salacious songs when uncorked, but it actually reduced the performance model's decibels in our interior sound level measurement at idle, while the noise level at a steady 70 miles per hour remained the same. Mashing on a left pedal resulted in the performance's standard carbon ceramic brakes bringing the car to a halt from 70 miles per hour in 160 feet, 11 more than a Cadillac Quartz-V and 17 feet greater than the distance recorded in the RS7 we tested previously. On our 300-foot skid pad, the Continental Conti Sport Contact 5P summer tires helped the all-wheel drive hatchback cling to pavement to the tune of 0.94 grams. Specific to the RS7 Performance is Audi's Dynamic Ride Control Suspension System. Unlike the standard RS7, which uses air springs, the RS7 Performance features traditional coil springs paired with a set of three-mode adjustable dampers that are connected diagonally front to rear. When placed in the softest damper setting comfort, the RS7 Performance's ride quality can induce backaches. Switch to the stiffest setting dynamic and you'll want to invest in a brace. The upside is that the Audi's body roll is kept to a minimum,